There is a really powerful statement from my coach, Chandra, who says, you must unlearn the way you were taught to suffer. Mm-hmm. And you do that through mindfulness. You do that through awareness and becoming really present. Hi, I'm Sarah Stewart, and you're watching Project Luminary.
Your mission and passion are one and the same, shifting the world to a greater sense of happiness through well-being. You, of course, grew up in a home where nutrition was highly valued. So what was it like at the dinner table when you were 5 years old?
I grew up in a really holistic environment. My parents were really committed to having us have this connection with nature. So whether it was us having our own garden or going to my grandparents' farm, they were just so committed to this holistic life. My dad, he had a very different belief system around raising kids. He taught about things that are more traditional now, but back then were not as accepted. So meditation, quieting your mind, looking within. So when I would get in trouble, he would teach my brother and I how to basically sit with ourselves and quiet our nervous system and process the thoughts that were going on in our minds. Instead of like being grounded and like feeling bad, we would have to write out these like positive affirmations. My parents always just let us be whoever we wanted to be and just continue to inspire that in us, really telling me I could do anything and really supporting that side of it. They were really committed to creating that space for us.
When you were just 15 years old, you were discovered by a modeling agency and suddenly find yourself in the spotlight. You have said that fear and anxiety engulfed your entire world from there on out. What did that world look like?
It was night and day. I went into it thinking, I have a really great head on my shoulders, I'm gonna be fine. But within the first week, started having severe body insecurity issues. This disconnect for me lasted for 10 years. I'm still shameful and embarrassed to even talk about it because it's such a sad place in my life. But I'm open to it now because I know how many women need to hear it. During that time, I was pill popping. I was working out for 4 hours a day. I was doing everything I could to stay a certain size because my entire livelihood and my income relied on it. The strange part about it was that during the same time, my father was also curing himself with food of terminal cancer. So I had two very different views on food at the time. It was like making me really sick emotionally and mentally, and yet healing my dad on the physical level of something that was gonna take his life. All my experiences were based upon my figure. I remember just thinking, I have no one to call. I don't even feel comfortable calling my family because I grew up in this amazing, beautiful, holistic environment. This is so embarrassing to call them and tell them that I'm dying because of a disorder that I have with food.
Your story of resilience is incredibly inspiring, and it really seems that out of one of your darkest moments came immense clarity around your purpose. What was the defining moment that made you realize you wanted to be a vehicle for empowering change?
I ended up really taking care of my body and healing on a physical level. But the crazy thing is your mind goes with you everywhere you go. So if you're still having these programmed subconscious beliefs of your self-worth, self-esteem, and they're not in connection with your truth and how you really feel, there's gonna be that moment that you wake up and say, wow, I tried to run for as long as I could, but yet I'm still having the anxiety every time I walk by a mirror. At that time, I had already gotten nutrition certifications. I was coaching people about the power of food. I was sitting across from one of my clients, and I remember so clearly thinking, wow, I'm having anxiety about how much sugar is in this drink, and it was a green juice. And I was like, the work isn't over. I have to go back to the basics. I have to go back to my mind, and I have to be willing to dive deep into that to heal that. And that moment like changed everything.
You are now inspiring thousands of people across the US to reclaim their sense of self and love of their bodies. Tell us about what this amazing work looks like now.
I ended up switching my company completely from nutrition coaching to more mindset coaching. So when I named my company Holistically Slim, it wasn't about slimming down in terms of weight. It's about holistically looking at all areas of your life and the parts that aren't serving you. I think the biggest thing that I see so often is that disordered eating and yo-yo dieting is much less about food and movement, and it's really more about reprogramming thinking and what's going on in your mind. The problem is when you're distracting yourself from food or distracting yourself from the emotional feelings that you're going through when you want to go eat or binge or maybe not go work out, you're actually suppressing the emotion, and that's the most important thing that you need to connect with. So what I found is when there's a certain area of your life that isn't serving you, whether it's your career, your relationship, maybe you're having issues with your family, those things actually inspire and trigger the food cravings. They're the things that are actually fueling that part of yourself because you're not happy. Maybe you need to work on your relationship or your career. Maybe you need to find something that inspires you. Maybe you need to find something that powerfully shifts those areas of your life because those will directly impact how you take care of yourself. I always say, if you have a purpose and a reason to be here, you're gonna wanna stick around.
If there's anyone out there struggling with self-love, what would you tell them?
Clients come in and they feel so much guilt and shame around the fact that negative self-talk isn't going away. And I think that we have to really give ourselves permission to have it and allow ourselves to actually feel into it. There's this process of being able to build a toolkit so that when you do have the talk, you can basically use breath work or meditation or affirmations, intentions, visualizations to basically help you move through it in a very positive way. We can't control what's going on in our mind, but we can control the action that comes after it. I really hope to inspire people to look within and to be able to dig up those emotions and those feelings that exist within them and to be able to let them go, because that's what's going to really encourage permanent, long-lasting change.